Genesis Part 1 is a very unique map among Ark maps. It is a map that is split up into five biomes: the bog, the Arctic, the ocean, the lunar, and the volcanic. Now, the volcanic is a biome that is really hard. And, well, I decided I'm gonna be spending 100 days there. Well, I'm gonna be beating Genesis 1 within 100 days, and so I'm just gonna be in the volcanic for that. Which only rules are right here, and, well, let's get into the video. Day 1, as per usual, I started off by importing my character. So spawning in, I had this area in the volcanic that I knew about right next to a teleport that I could go to, and nothing deadly would spawn there for the most part. So, well, that was the beginning of my day. But before I went there, I had to wait for HLNA to stop yapping, which is a problem I have everywhere in this video. HLNA does not stop yapping. So when I got to the designated area, I just, you know, did some basics, gathered some fiber, and tried to solve my hyperthermia. So it turns out 3 pieces of cloth were not enough to solve my hyperthermia, so I had to build a temporary thatch hut so that I could not die in the heat. So I found this magmasaur next to my base, and I thought, well, it looks stuck, it might be glitched out, I'm gonna try to kill it. It taught me my place really quickly, and I ran off. So I decided, because of the overwhelming heat, I would go to the ocean to run a mission, Wave Ray 64. It's a really easy early game mission that, well, you can just do off the bat in the ocean, and it gives pretty good loot. Now, I still had a bit of thassilophobia from Fjorders, so I was constantly being paranoid looking around the ocean, thinking something would come and kill me, like, I don't know, a cloud of megalodons that shred them through a basilisk within 5 seconds. But nope, there was nothing. The ocean in Genesis is a lot more tame. So I've actually played a little bit of Genesis before, and I spent most of it just grinding out Wave Ray 64 for hexagons, because I was still really early game when I first played it. So I just grinded out Wave Ray 64 on Alpha. And it's honestly a really fun mission. After a few runs of it, I got this really good hazard hat, which gives a lot of protection against heat, so I decided I was going to go back to the volcanic because I could actually tolerate the heat there now. And this is my loot haul from running Wave Ray 64 on Alpha, which, pretty good loot haul, because I was running it for, like, most of the day. Day 2, and Raptor Claws is here. He disappears, like, halfway through the playthrough. So, in the meantime, while I was still poor and wanted some hexagons, I decided to run the Dead Heat mission. So, it was pretty straightforward and simple, except for one thing they don't tell you. On the path, there are these lava eruptions that are around, and they have poisonous gas, which drains your oxygen for 20 seconds, and you can't get rid of it without a gas mask, which they can get me really low. And turns out, there's three directly in the path of Dead Heat. Which makes it a really, really annoying mission to run. I hate this mission. Also, that little sound that Gallimimus makes gets really annoying really quickly. I hate hearing it. So, with only 2 minutes and 41 seconds to spare, I beat the mission, which, you know, I never ran that mission before. First time, and I'm not good on a Gallimimus, but at least I beat it. Here's a demonstration of how much I hate those gas bursts when I was trying to do beta. But don't worry, on my way to get my stuff back, I got hit by another gas burst, which had left me really low. So I gave up on doing Dead Heat and tried to go towards the Gotta Go Fast mission, and then got mauled at the terminal. So yeah, if you couldn't tell, the volcanic's a little bit deadly. So, using the hexagons I got, I
Let's do
used some
this
pay to
again.
win methods and made myself a set of ghillie. Holy crap, Lomas, I look just like me in the 100 Days Extinction Wasteland video. Sorry for the terrible Peter Griffin impression. Anyways, I had some plans for building, so for the first time ever, I'm learning adobe structures. Damn, I really be practicing for Scorched Earth, which I'm doing next, by the way. It should be coming out eventually. Probably in 2 weeks, considering how fast I get these things done. Anyways, I ran more dead heat. I promise I'll end day two soon. It's not like I'm not even halfway through it. Alright, so using the hexagons, I bought some clay for adobe structures because adobe looks nice, and this time I'm actually going to build a house. That's right, a finished and complete base will be coming out of this playthrough. And just look at that foundation. It's looking really nice. Now time to build the walls. My grandfather is actually a plasterer, so I definitely know a lot about plastering walls and building them and making sure the proper foundation is there. And just look at this wall. See, look, I properly plastered the wall. Maybe I won't bring shame to the dinner table now, considering I just sit on my ass all day on my computer. Yeah, if you think I'm making all these jokes in good fun, nah, I'm actually making them all in bad fun. Anyways, I tried to get up to the out of the frying pan mission, because I thought it was really easy because the hexagons were low, and I could do it on foot. I even failed at getting up, and I had to teleport back to base, even though I was right next to my base, but I was low enough to where if I tried to go back down to my base, I would just take fall damage and die. I started off day three by getting a nice drink of oil. That's right, I have been drinking nothing but oil for the past 3 days. My character is now oil. Alright, I am literally American. And now we're, holy shit, almost 7 minutes into this video. I was on like day 24 on Crystal Isles, 7 minutes into the video. I even mentioned it at exactly 7 minutes what day I was on. I am going really. Should I speed this up? I should definitely speed this video up, so I'm probably not gonna do so. So, my entire morning was spent waiting for the Stego to tame up because I couldn't really do anything because I needed more drink arrows, which I needed the Stego to get more drink arrows because the Stego gave me more narcotics than I can ever gather. I began messing with custom recipes because I need something better than berries to keep me fed for the time being. I ended up making something called the Berry Cake, which is made of berries. It's just made of pure large amounts of berries. It is very unhealthy to eat more than two of these at once. You will die of a sugar overdose. All the sugar is natural, but because of how many fruits are in that thing, it makes you instantly type 4 diabetic. But I claimed a life of a Magwasaur, so that went pretty well. Maybe I should just stop making as many jokes as I'm making on stuff, so then I could, in terms, decrease the video length, so then it won't end up 3.5 hours long. Or who knows, I could just make this video 3.5 hours long, but then nobody would actually watch it because nobody's willing to hear me talk for 3.5 hours. Well, I started adding some pillars to my house, and it makes it look better, but those pillars floating on just the walls looks really awkward. I need to get some pillars down there on the foundations. Another Magmasaur life claim. I'm starting a war. Now, end of day three, and I'm looking to tame an Exankey, so it'll be day four really soon, so you're getting spared on the length for day three. Oh, yeah, if you're wondering, it's day four now, and day three was 2 minutes and 3 seconds. Yeah, so kind of crazy, but while the Ankey was taming, I noticed a Rex near my base, and I thought, well, that'd be a really good early game mount to have, so I'm gonna make a trap and trap it. Then began some Rex drinking. No 1984s this time, 100 narcotics were not spawned in. My bad, sorry if that entire thing was too fast to process, because I'm gonna make time lapses that are faster than 16 times speed later. Anyways, this may be known, but I actually like taming more than building and being productive. I just like taming stuff that I need. So, I found this thorny dragon and thought, well, that'd be a hell of a good tame. I should get that. Anyways, Rex tamed and I got it out of the trap, and now You know what? I'm feeling merciful. Day 4 is going to be the shortest one yet. Because we're on day 5 now. Which, I have the Rex saddle. The Rex is in action, and this is the best team I have right now. Oh, yeah, I found a glitch. Then Helen and I started yapping again. So now that I could defend myself, I decided I wanted to do Gotta Go Fast. But wait, first I gotta clip the glitch and Helena is yapping again. Oh, my bad. HLNA. Yapping again, because I found another glitch. I ran Gotta Go Fast on all the difficulties. It's fun. Then I ran it again, and again, and again, and again. I really wanted those hexagons for the clay to make the adobe base. And when I finished running the missions, I had gotten 10,000 hexagons to spend. And I was making a lot of base progress. I even finished the first room. Then I spent the last of my hexagons making the back room of the base, which I would eventually get to working on later. Day 6 and HLNA is yapping again. Oh yeah, I also didn't make a tribe yet, so now I made a tribe at day 6. Not as bad as Aberration when I made a tribe on day 10, but still. Yeah, I found a high-level Allosaurus and made a trap, because I really want an Allosaurus. Yeah, so just all of day 6 was basically dedicated to taming this one aloe, meaning day 6 might take the cake as the new shortest day in here, because we're already... My producers get really mad at me if I go on for too long. By my producers, I mean me. I don't have any producers. What, you think I actually am running a business off of this and making money? No, I'm just a random teenager making a video out in my bedroom. But, yeah, end of day 6 and the aloe is tamed. Day 7 and, well, HLNA is yapping yet again. Every time I collect a glitch, HLNA will not shut up. Another yap session from HLNA. More HLNA certified yapping. Whoop-dee-doo. HLNA is, guess what, yapping again. If I collect all 30 glitches, it automatically counts as a mission complete. Thanks for the zero hexagons, Ark. What was the challenge? Oh my god, I have to listen to the HLNA yap again.
Shut up, HLNA. Shut the hell up, HLNA. I'm tired of hearing you speak.
Oh, thank god it's over. I'm back to wood harvesting, and that was only a fourth of my day. Jeez. Hey, look, Dead Heat and Alpha. I want you to know this is only the 9th hour of the day. I spent 6 whole in-game hours, arc hours. That's, do the math on that, it's divide an hour by 24. I spent all of that time just collecting glitches and HLNA would not shut up. I put the loot I got from doing Dead Heat on Alpha a few times into another storage box because my initial one ran out of space.
No, no, HLNA, shut up, shut up.
I tried to tame this 150 aloe to go with my male aloe, and it died.
HLNA, shut up, shut up, shut up. Please, HLNA, just shut up.
Oh, yeah, I found this alpha carno, and I killed it. Yeah, I really don't like HLNA. If you couldn't tell, I'm starting to just scream at HLNA whenever HLNA yaps.
HLNA, shut up!
Day 8 and... No. No. No! Alright, well, later in the day, I failed to run one hell of a treasure hunt. Because, well, it was on aloe, and the aloe doesn't have a lot of health, and there's Arthropoda, which do a lot of damage back to you. Then I started up hunting the heat on Gamma, thinking that my weak Allosaurus, not even imprinted, could do this mission. Oh boy, was I mistaken. So now, day 9, I'm out of an aloe and just with a low-level Rex. So, I needed to get on my grind set.
as much. I see you left a mark, a burn down my skin, skin, skin. I don't know where I am and where you begin. I need your discipline, I need your help, I need your discipline.
So we're on day 12 now, and I hope you enjoyed that Nine Inch Nails, because I enjoyed the song. I didn't enjoy what happened in the footage. It was terrible to go through. I lost like almost everything. Anyways, I got into a brawl, nigh a scrap, with the Perlovia, and the Perlovia lost. It died. It got brutally slaughtered. Day 13, and I got the level 114 female Axalosaurus treatment. I finally tried it out of the frying pan. Then I realized the second area it wanted me to go to was way out of my reach. I can't do that right now. So now I've learned to hate volcano eruptions, but they happen like every other day, because they're like a combination of the earthquake and aberration, because, well, the earth quakes, but then they're also like meteor showers of extinction, because they launch out projectiles that can kill you instantly. End of day 13, I was looking for allies, but then I found this 168 Rex, which I did the math, I had the strength to tame, so I was going for that Rex. At this point, I had become so paranoid in the volcanic whenever I was taming something that that every 30 seconds I was looking up to make sure the volcano wasn't erupting. Hey look, day 14, the Rex finally went down. But right as that happened, volcano started to erupt, but this time I had an idea. If I just got out of there, right, like, I got out of there in the sense that I teleported out of there, then that'd be out of render and the Rex would be invincible to the meteor? Hopefully. Anyways, later that day, I went back and the Rex tamed. But I've learned my lesson. I'm not using this Rex for combat. No. You see, if I get imprinted Rexes instead, then I have a disposable source of Rexes and I could actually get a good thing going. So I instantly began preparing another Rex trap to get a male Rex. Yeah, when teleporting, it makes like this cool little silhouette of my character. Now, it's probably not intentional, but I think it looks kind of cool with the red armor on. Looks a little weird with Gilly on, but with the red armor on it, that could definitely look a lot cooler. HLNA, if you don't shut up, I'm gonna... Anyways, I tried to run hide and sink as a mission, but then it wanted me to go underwater, and I still had a bit of thalassophobia from Fjordr. I don't want to get attacked by all the nasty stuff underwater. It can kill me, like, instantly. So I got a little too scared of it. Day 15, and I found this 156 male X-Rex right next to where I tamed the first one. Boom, catch in the bag, and now the catch being pelted with tranquilizing arrows to hopefully knock it out, so then meat can be shoved. Yeah, of course, right before I knocked it out, a volcano had to erupt, so I got paranoid. But before that, it was like 11:30 on New Year's Eve before I decided to go back. So I paused, and well, I spent the New Year's Eve downstairs. Alright, I think this is New Year's, around here, like, happy 2024. So, you could say the taming of this Rex spanned over multiple years. Then a Magmasaur showed up and kinda threatened the Rex, which, if it lowered my taming effectiveness even 1%, I would have gone into GCM and instantly deleted it. Boom! 156 Rex tamed. Now I have a breeding pair. On the end of day 15, the first egg was to hatch in the middle of my living room. Yeah, I made something called a meat burger. It's made of raw meat and cooked meat. Before you say, well, actually, it's a room in your base. No, it's a living room. Think about this. I'm not dying in the room, so then it's not the dying room. I'm actually alive and well in that room. So I'm living in that room. It is a living room. Think about it. Don't think about it. I have no idea what I'm talking about. And look at that. First Rex. So while waiting for that Rex to raise up for the imprint timer, I decided I would play Dodo Ball. So after becoming world champion in Dodo Ball, in fact, I am just that good. I beat all three difficulties on one of the easiest missions in the game. We don't count that though. But after doing some Dodo Ball, I realized I gotta make time for my family, and I went back to my base to raise the Rex. But then, right back to Dodo Ball, you see, the World Championship is coming up and I gotta train up to become the Dodo Ball Champion. So that was actually me doing Dodo Ball 7 separate times, but then I made a mistake. So I crowd up Rarkle because he wanted Superior Kibble, I didn't have that, and I threw him back out, not realizing that I already did that before and he wants Superior Kibble again. And I was still on PvP for some reason, so he got knocked out and Rexes are out for a while. Day 17, and don't worry, I can always get a new one. Yeah, another yap session from HLNA. Alright, bam, now I'm the master of the bog rally. And it gave me an ascendant rifle. An ascendant rifle, that's so good! So, on Rarkle, the Rex I could not fully imprint because he got cryosickened, I decided I would actually go on a meat run and a leveling run on this Rex because it is my best creature right now. Alright, so now I'm running the Aloe and Goodbye. Aloe and Goodbye, like, hello there! Actually, that sounds British. Ugh. Don't worry, I've done hunt missions on Genesis 2, because they're definitely really hard on Genesis 2, guys. Trust me, hunt missions on Genesis 2 are definitely the hardest missions I have ever done. I am not trained to pay aid by the FDA to tell you that... Wait a minute. The FDA? Ugh. There are people trying to convince us Alpha Basilisk are real. They're not. Yeah, if I thought HLNA was bad before, wait till you see HLNA during hunt missions every trek. Huh, would you look at that? Hold up a second, let me scan this. I should scan this. Please just shut up. Anyways, my Rex is pretty easily able to beat the Aloe, and I went from saying Aloe to Goodbye. You see what I did there? Because the Aloe, you know, I'll never be funny. But turns out there was an entire pack of them there waiting for me, which, no big deal. It's not like they have bleed damage in that. Alright, now I'm doing one hell of a treasure hunt gamma because I need hexagons. Hexagons allow me to get clay, which allow me to build the base, which allow me to actually build a house. HLNA does not show up in this one. Like, with law. Let me scan this real quick. Hold up, I should scan this. Huh, would you look at that? Aha, I found something. But then I got scared because the volcano erupted and ran. So HLNA was yapping again, but I'm going to do the bog beatdown. And let me just say for this one, the spear went crazy. Anyways, I wanted more loot, so I did it again. Now I got what I wanted. A tech helmet. But, you see, I demanded more. So I went to the Mid-Arctic. Well, I just went to the Arctic. So I could do the Belt Fjord Tough. Yeah, I really showed them who is Belt Fjord Tough. I'm so funny, guys. You know, I make all these funny jokes. Funny, guys. I guess another silhouette for my collection. Now, look at this. I'm making a second floor. Character development. Boom. Look at this. My house is coming together really nicely. Day 19, and just look at this house. It's coming along really well. I made a secret little cookery room behind the staircase. Now I've got a view. It's not a very good view because I'm kind of like under a roof and like half in a cave, but it's a view. Yeah, I've been raising the next Rex. Its name is Rollprint. Just like full imprint. That's the backstory. There. Yeah, I made some dye for my stuff. Then I just learned some engrams. Anyways, now I'm running Magma Medley Melee. I did some Magma Medley, but not Melee. And that got me Tech Leggings and an Ascendant Mining Drill. Then I discovered I can't use the Tech Leggings ability in the Genesis simulation. And that's really annoying because I spent a while getting those. Magma Medley Melee is no joke. But I learned this while imprinting my Rex. Day 20, in order to fill up my base a little, I made some taxidermy bases. But now wait for another imprint timer, so it's time to become the Dodo Ball champion and the world championship. But, you know, always gotta make time to get that full imprint on the Rex. Then, I tried to knock out a Kentro, because I thought it could be good for mission-related reasons. So, I also got some more base work done. And now, because I'm starting to breed up a Rex army, and I've been collecting eggs for the past while, I thought it'd probably be good if I made a designated hatchery for them. So then I wanted to run Aloe and Goodbye on Beta, because I thought Gamma was a breeze, so maybe I'll do Beta. Oh boy, was I a mistake! Now, I'm running one hell of a treasure hunt. It was easy. Anyways, I did those missions for some hexagons so that I can get some base work done. Well, because I'm building, now's probably prime time for another. Is it really a montage? It's more like a collection of small clips that don't sync with the music at all.
Why is it always to you? Why is it always to you?
has happened to you?
Anyways, that was a montage. So, remember, every 20 days I can tame something outside of the volcanic, and I chose a Basilisaur, and it died almost instantly, which, that's fun. And now I'm running Kingslayer on beta. I did it for the 10,000 hexagons. And it was really easy. It only took me 2 Rexes to take down Kingslayer. But then I thought, well, that was a breeze. I should try Alpha. And, ooh, Alpha! Anyways, now I'm running the mission We Will Rock You. No, no, not the song, the mission. Anyways, I kind of tamed a Megalania and lost it, as you can see in the montage that happened, so now I'm taming a female Megalania. I ran Hunt in the Heat while I was waiting for it to tame.
Now that's what I call a hunt.
And with a little bit of editing magic, the Megalania is tamed now. I ran one hell of a treasure hunt on beta too. And now I'm having a style change of my character. I wanted to wear some desert cloth. Anyways, dare I say it, Megalania are slightly underrated. Yeah, I've been skipping over a lot of HLNA's yapping because, well, nobody wants to hear me scream at HLNA for like 30 minutes straight. Anyways, with this Megalania, I had an idea. I would use it to steal a Magmasaur egg. So I kind of just loitered on the ceiling above the egg, waiting to mentally prepare myself. Another silhouette for my collection. Anyway, I'm running the Cheaper by the Pack mission now. And oh my god, why do the bog missions have so many tracks? There's 140. You know, the volcanic ones have like 70, and I like that. I like 70, it's not too much, but 140? It's like 40 tracks in between, and then I tried to run beta, and this thing ramps up really fast with beta. Now I'm doing Swamp Placid. But I have another construction project, a bridge. So, day 35 now, and I got mauled by a Morphodon and one hell of a treasure hunt alpha, thinking I could do it. I could not do it. So after that, I was still on a mission run, so I decided to do Alone Goodbye Beta. And I was on a mission run because I had some Rexes with good saddles now. And I also did Kingslayer on beta. Day 36, and I made up a bunch of refining forges so that I could get an industrial forge. Anyways, I went out to the southern half of the volcano so that I could find a Megalania. So then I could get an imprinted Megalania. Oh, yeah, also I'm gonna mention, so my main joke delivery is deadpan. I prefer to deliver some deadpan jokes here and there. And even then, right now I'm speaking in like my normal tone and it sounds more energetic than whenever I was speaking in Fjorder. Bam, Megalania egg. Wada boom, wada bam, we got a hatched egg now. The Megalania is named Maelstrom. I started work on a platform for my industrial forge outside. I also did some more work on the Rex pen. I went on a metal run day 37. And now I just need to wait for metal to finish smelting for the industrial forge. Anyways, I made a fridge. And I also made 6 forges to, you know, increase my metal production 6-fold for that forge. Anyways, look, another silhouette. I also went to the Lunar to harvest some electronics, and before you say, well, actually, the Lunar is not part of the volcanic, you cannot go there because you're not going there for a mission. Well, shut up. The Lunar is harder than the volcanic, so theoretically I should be able to go there more often? Just think about it. Anyways, I try to do Hunt in the Heat on beta, except the Dimorphodons absolutely bodied me. So, I ran Kingslayer beta again. The reason I'm running Kingslayer beta is because it's really easy. I can do it on just one Rex. I've also been making up a bunch of shotgun bullets for my shotgun because, well, I've always been like out of bullets. And also, I'm still looking for good aloes. I have a Rex army, but ignore that. I need good aloes, I guess. But this time, I wasn't settling on like 114s, 108s, no, I was settling on the good aloes. Now I'm doing the Summit Tour mission. Day 39, and bam, I can now craft the Industrial Forge. And now waiting for hard polymer to craft to make a chemistry bench. The fact that I can't abuse organic polymer on this map is really sad. Fjorder spoiled me. Aberration spoiled me. Everything has just spoiled me with organic polymer. But this time I actually have to do hard grueling manual labor to get it. Wait, do you see that in the top left corner? If you don't, let me enhance for a second. Literally 1984. Anyways, end of day 59, I ran Don't Fear the Reaper King, and these Reaper Princes were really annoying because they didn't have any charge light. So, I got this Feather Light, but I have something to reveal to you. This isn't actually 100 Days Genesis Volcanic, it's actually including the Lunar. It's 100 Days Genesis' hardest biomes, except Volcanic just has more of a tune and I spent most of the time in the Volcanic anyway. So I'm kinda just like free to come and go to the Lunar and tame whatever I need there, except I didn't tame any Tech Rexes. Also, I gathered up some element shards, so now I was going to make some element out of a mission terminal. Anyways, trying out of the frying pan again, but I'm actually trying to go to the next location. So then, the last part of the mission takes place in the volcano, and then, boom, it made the volcano erupt just like that. And now I'm hatching the last of the Rex eggs. So, while waiting for the imprint, more hide and sink. But, you know, back to imprinting now. But back to hide and sink alpha now. Okay, back to imprinting. Now to being AFK? Day 43, I honestly tried to find something interesting and I couldn't. So I tamed a Galley Mimas. Well, I tried to tame one. I never actually tamed it. I just knocked it out. And I don't even think I knocked it out. Day 44, and turns out I am one wreck short, so I gotta hatch another one. I did Spy versus Spino. on Gamma.
You bagged yourself quite a trophy.
Anyways, I'm about to do the fourth montage of this video. Day 52, and I wanted to attempt Magma Medley Melee on beta. It started off easy enough. I got up on a rock, which allowed me to get away from most of the stuff. But then, Wave 4 came in, and did not go very well for me. Day 53, and I'm running the Bulb Dog basketball mission, Space Jam. I hated it. Don't like it. I've also been grinding up some berries for a very specific reason. You see, on day 55, again, there will be 4 Giga spawn in 3 parks, all 180. Now the reason this is because of Alpha Hunt missions. Alpha Hunt missions are not really possible without a Giga, and it's stupid. Yeah, I started storing soups in the fridge because, well, I had some lying around for missions. But I kinda want hexagons to get gunpowder because I'm trying to get a bunch of bullets for the Corrupted Master Controller. So I ran Kingslayer in beta. I ran out of the frying pan and I know you're fucking there, go. Sorry, I'm playing Phasmophobia. Like, actively while editing. I'm just waiting in a room for the ghost. The weekly challenge, it can't hunt, so that's nice. And I got this 400% shot. Oh, I think I saw someone on dots. No, there's nothing on dots, but anyway, yeah, I got a 400% shotgun. On day 55, I made up some exceptional kibble. I went to a Giga that I knew was summoned in because, well, I was ready to tame it. I got it in the trap and, well, started the infinite shrinking process that is knocking out a Giga. Seriously, why is it so forceful? So, the Giga shrinking was going well until I realized it wasn't in the trap and it started moving. And then, eventually, it turned into it full scale running off and I had to chase it down. Now, I kind of enjoyed it running off. I wanted that thing to fear me. Wait. Yeah, but it was terrified of me. The fact that I was shooting it with harmless strength darts. Day 56, I hatched up some sun god sacrifices. I did all of it to befriend this Kark. But to tame a Kark, I need to commit a mass genocide with it, so I went around killing stuff. Anyways, I'm doing that again and sacrificing another infant to the sun god. But then I remembered there's too much smog everywhere because I live in downtown LA, so I decided I would just feed it to this nearby cart instead. Disclaimer, that's actually a joke. I actively insult California every chance I can get because they can't tolerate cold, unlike me. Then I bred the Karks because I thought, well, an imprinted Kark would probably do really well in a mission. Anyways, now I'm making up even more narcotics because I still need to get another Giga. I have the Karks, now I just need another Giga. So how about now I do the last montage of the video? That's right, I'm breaking out more Nine Inch Nails. Just I'll keep doing you, Bill. So you'd never guess it, but I spent all of day 65 just raising up some gigas, which then flowed into day 66. Jeez, most of the days just got progressively shorter. Like, it started off, day 2 went to like 7 minutes. It was like 4.5 minutes long, and now, like, these days are just a few seconds. That means there's more monotony, which means I'm getting closer to the boss fight. Day 67 was also spent raising up the gigas. Something interesting will happen soon, I promise. Day 68, I also just... I put eggs inside of a fridge. That's it. I mean, I made a bunch of med brews and I made some beer. It's the end of day 68, and the gigas are finally done. I'm sorry that went by so quick there. I was just waiting around for the imprint timers. But day 69, and I'm running Kingslayer on Alpha. That's right, with 4 gigas it should be possible. So the first one went fine enough, it's just that my giga took a beating, so I would probably have to get another giga in for the May boost. Now, my initial giga is getting low, so I bred out 2 more and had them fight the Rex. Yeah. One of my gigas still died there. I went in with 4 gigas, all made with the good saddles, and they all died. Well, one died, but they all could have died if I didn't go in with good saddles. Then I got the full tech fit going. Now I'm running the mission on beta. But this rock elemental is really weak to my giga, it almost instantly died. So after that, I went over to the beer shack and checked how many I had. Then I was bored, so I went out and tamed some stuff from all across the volcanic. Anyways, I made up some more element because I did a mission that gave me a tech rifle. It's hunting my moonlight, I believe. So then I could get a tech rifle for the master controller. I had an AR, a shotgun, and a fabricated sniper. I was making sure that nothing would go wrong. But before I do the master controller, I still need to complete 2 more missions to access him. So I did the extraction on a Giga, day 71. I repeat, do not do the extraction if you want to have fun. It was terrible. There was fire everywhere. It was everywhere. But now, last mission. I'm doing the summit tour on beta. We made it! Woo! Day 72, and now I've grabbed all the stuff out of my vault. I have just about everything needed to take down the master controller. And I'm going on with style, I mean, just look at me. Okay, it's only the hardest boss in the game. What could go wrong?
Please, I'll stop hacking this teleport. I hate this.
have another go.
Thank you.